Hello friends, in this video we are going to see how to determine whether the given signal is energy or a power signal. So let's take a simple example. X of n is equal to u of n. So basically it is a step function, unit step function. So what I will do first, I will plot this with respect to n. So actually this function is like this. For any value of n from 0 to infinity, I have the signal value as 1. So this is a basic fundamental signal. So this is a u of n. So we need to check whether this signal is energy signal or power signal. So the first step, we'll find out what is the energy of this signal by applying a formula. So formula is E infinity equals summation n minus infinity to plus infinity x of n mod x of n square. Now, since the signal exists only from 0 to infinity, hence I will cut short this summation limit from 0 to infinity like this. And the signal is u of n, means what? For every value of n, the x of n is 1. So it is 1 square. So simple summation I have. Next, what I will do, since the number is independent of n, let it be n of any value, but the signal will have 1 square, meaning 1 as the final value. So I have this 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 and it can go up to infinity. Meaning I have to add 1 up infinite times. So obviously every addition the values keep on increasing. 1, then it become 2, then become 3, and it can go up to infinity. So I can say E infinity is infinity. This is the first lead I will get. E infinity is infinity implies signal is not energy signal. So we have eliminated one possibility of a signal to become a energy signal. Now we need to check for the power. For discrete time, the formula for power is P infinity equals limit n tends to infinity, time period is 2n plus 1, summation n minus n to plus n mod x of n square. So once again, the limits for summation will change because it is a unit step signal, exists only from 0 to n. So I will get P infinity as limit n tend to infinity 1 upon 2n plus 1 summation from 0 to n, and signal is having a value 1, hence 1 square. So here also I need to add 1, but this time it won't be for infinite time. It will be restricted up to capital N. So this becomes 1 plus 1 plus 1, but this is only up to n times. Now here it becomes limit n tend to infinity 1 upon 2n plus 1. You must be thinking this will be n. Hold on. Small n is not starting from 1, it is starting from 0. So keep this in mind. Do not forget to take account of this n equal to 0. So n equal to 0 is the first instant where one more 1 will get added to the n. So I will get an addition n plus 1. Plus 1 is for this instant where n equal to 0. Now we have to solve this limit. For solving this limit, I will take n common from numerator and denominator. So it becomes 1 plus 1 plus 1. Why have I taken n common? Because this is a common feature that I can cancel out. N tends to infinity, meaning n is not equal to infinity. So I can cancel this. So n get cancelled, I will get this, and applying limits, I get p infinity as 1 plus limit n tend to infinity 1 by n upon 2 plus limit n tend to infinity 1 by n. So if I apply the limit, I will get 1 upon infinity, 1 upon infinity. Anything upon infinity will give you 0. So this is 1 plus 0 upon 2 plus 0. So I'm getting p infinity as 1 upon 2. So what I'm getting? Power I'm getting as a finite number. Hence the signal is power signal. This is the end of a problem where we have decided whether the signal is energy or a power signal first by calculating energy. If it is infinite, then we calculate power, and here power is finite, hence signal is a power signal. Thank you.